The purpose of the march is to petition the president to pardon the jailed King Buyelekhaya Dalindyebo from prison. As a matter of extreme urgency and unconditionally. We are expecting a large number of people. Firstly, there will also be a band that will be leading the march from the St. John's Church. The Council of Churches South Africa International is a fellowship of churches. It's a fellowship of community-based organizations. It's a fellowship of faith-based organizations. It's a fellowship of institutions. It is a fellowship of organizations and individuals. Now, we are having people from the Khoisan community, for instance. The King himself will also be here in person. And a number of organizations that are also part and parcel of our organization, the Council of Churches South Africa, or COCSAI, they will also be here. The call for pardoning of the King by the President is because, firstly, the King is alleged to have committed the crimes in 1994, 1995, and finally sentenced in 1996. But unfortunately for him, a piece of legislation that was promulgated in 2003 and passed into law in 2005 is the piece of legislation that was used against him. He was convicted under that piece of legislation. That's number one. Number two, the King should have not been convicted in the first place. Number three, he should not have been jailed. Like all other presiding officers, the judiciary should have protected him, because at the time he was presiding over cases under customary law, which is recognized by the Constitution of the Republic of South Africa. The judiciary absolutely failed to protect one of their presiding officers, because he was a recognized presiding officer under customary laws, which are also enshrined in the Constitution under Section 12 of the Constitution of the Republic of South Africa. Upon his release, he must immediately ascend his throne again and become King of the Abatembus, because in the first place, as the Abatembus, together with the Council of Churches South Africa International, we do not believe that he had committed any crime. In terms of the Constitutional Court ruling yesterday, we respect the judgment that was given by the Constitutional Court, and we do not point any fingers to anyone, including President Jacob Zuma. We do not know what actually transpired, because we were not involved, so there is nothing that we can really comment about in terms of him, of the judgment against him. But what we say, we do respect the rule of law in South Africa, including we respect the judiciary and as well as the customary laws. Yes, well, I think President Zuma has made his mark, and as President of the Republic of South Africa, I think the time has come for him to step aside and give chance to the next leader to lead the country.
So you're saying
for stability purposes. Now, we don't think the pardon will be affected by stepping aside or stepping down of President Jacob Zuma, because President Jacob Zuma is not the only one that takes decisions, you know, in government. There are also other people as well who are also involved, like the Minister of Justice, like the Deputy President, or any other person. So I don't think he is the only person that we are looking up to, since we are calling him as head of the government to pardon the King.